I mean, you say that PPD, of course, you never know what to think, but at the same time, people are wondering, is Secret just on another level? Are they just thinking in a completely different meta here in this patch during the drafting phase? So we'll find out, but I think you brought up a really great point, Jacob. I mean, they will be leaving a lot of other things open.
Wow.
Oh, all right. So taking away one of those core foundations we've talked about in the past for Secret in game number one, the Keeper of the Light.
You can see the reaction from Arteezy, right? I mean, that was a little bit surprising to Secret, and they're talking about, are we going to take the Tusk and let EG have likely that Leshrac pick?
And I do think it's more likely to see a Shaker opening here.
Yeah, if you look further back in the past, it's been very successful to ban out Poppy heroes rather than focus on some of their carry players. Mm-hmm. So taking him out of his comfort zone might actually benefit EG a lot, and I really, really favor their initial draft right here. I think that it's a great trade to take Leshrac and Earthshaker for a Tusk with no real obvious follow-up pick from Secret right now. Naturally, there's great heroes, Wisp being one of them.
So if you were Secret, would you prefer Lesh over Tusk as their first pick?
I mean, they know what they want, right? I have no idea what's going on in their head. But yes, I mean, personally, I would have preferred to take the Leshrac. I feel he's very strong right now. But they, having played anti-mates in the past and not being afraid of picking that up, they probably feel pretty comfortable playing against the Leshrac. The same way I imagine PPD might be comfortable playing up against the Tusk, assuming he gets the proper trade
right.
for it.
Yeah, I think that PPD Coddle ban is pretty much, you know, PPD drafts like a poker player. And he's showing right now that he has strength. He's showing that he has a hero that is a strategy that's going to counter Tusk. I actually really, based on what you just said, I really like that Dazzle pickup. I think EG would have definitely banned that out following the trend of banning puppy heroes.
I do assume right there's probably going to be a follow-up ban on the Bristleback on the side of EG. I don't really like the Bristleback on their side.
Then again, Bristleback hasn't been all that convincing in this tournament.
But Bristleback, yeah. I think Secret plays the Bristleback as a position two in the mid lane, where you have a Dazzle, you have a Tusk, both two more likely physical damage dealers, if you want to see it that way. I think it would be a good ban here.
I'm not saying that S4 and Poppy would have overlooked this fact, but the fact that Keep Up the Light is banned and you then follow up with the Leshrac pick sort of takes away that mana league opportunity to really shut down the Leshrac and keep him in place, because you want to run around with the Leshrac, so having mana league on you,
that's true.
Nullifies that ability. And now they're really down to 2 to 3 heroes in the game that really hard counters the Leshrac, one being the anti-mage that we know they like to play. Then there's Pogner, something we've seen other teams in the past ban out just because of Leshrac and Queen of Pain. And then finally the Nyx Assassin, something we haven't seen and I doubt we will see, although it is great against Leshrac.
Yeah, we haven't seen it this weekend yet. What do you think, Ben?
I'm surprised we haven't seen more Nyx Assassin. I think it's been a good pickup. It's very good versus Queen. But, I mean, some of the heroes is just like Tusk or Slark that we've seen a little bit just doesn't seem to fare too well. I really like the Naga Siren ban, though.
How do you
I think if they wanted to pick up Bristleback, Naga Siren, it kites it really, really well.
Right.
First, you just get off all the Warpath stacks when you Song of the Siren, just waiting it out, as well as just the Ensnare, because he's a hero that needs to move around a lot in fights just like Leshrac.
And we've been talking about how Secret have been so dominant and so consistent. That's really one of the only times in the last couple of months that I've seen Secret get roundly outdrafted, was giving up that support Naga Siren and Witcher Wyvern combo to EG in the Dota Pit final.
Oh. I really like this ban coming out. Anti-mates, obviously, but just because of the other games of this weekend, but also because Secret banned out the Phantom Lance and Naga Siren, which are the two most popular melee carries in the game at present time, and knowing that Secret likes to play the anti-mage, it was sort of we're going to ban these out because we know which melee carry we want if allowed.
Okay.
So, you know, it's a very obvious ban, but still.
I would also say that it states that they most likely will have Lesh as a core position. I mean, it's kind of a given, but since Shaker plus Leshrac as a combo is not that great, yes, there can be another support next to it where Universe just plays an offlane Shaker. But it gives away that it's most likely a core position, Lesh.
Yeah, well, it does look like more and more as we're going through the drafting phase that EG less worried about giving away their hand a little bit too much, but more just trying to bait out some other shows from Secret, saying, all right, well, listen, you might know what strategy we're going with, but what do you have left? We're going to ban out these foundations. How are you going to switch it up in game number one and trying to change the tempo here?
I think if you go deeper into the analysis, it's also obvious that evil geniuses have a much harder time losing their towers and being pushed down. down because of the already the AoE blast they have on creep waves.
That's a great. He preemptively picks a Razor.
Yeah, pre-counter the Bristle.
He leaves the Bristle in a pool, and he probably knew that already during the banning phase that he just doesn't want to ban the hero because he's going to pick the counter towards it before S4 will get the chance to even get an opportunity of picking that Bristle back.
All right, so now really posing the question to Seeker. All right, well, what else have you got? We took out the Keeper of the Light. We took out three of those other heroes that you could play in that carry position.
So guys, I'm interested to hear what you guys think. Do we see an explicit counter to the Tusk here beyond the fact that we just think Universe is that good on Earthshaker?
Well, I don't think so. I think it can just be countered by really, really good positioning. I think a lot of the time teams fear the snowball instead of trying to play well around it. It's like if you're rolling teammates in, they're all clumped up. And if you hit them with like a two-man Echo or, you know, a two-man Fissure, Leshrac, Splitter, like it clumping up is generally viewed as very, very bad in Dota.
Right.
The Winter Wyvern. I mean, we talked about that so much on day one, kind of slipping through here in the grand finals, but does get secured by EG with, of course, the Wisp on the other side for Secret.
I just feel like, once again, you know, Hani talked about it with the Razor pick. I feel like, once again, with the Winter Wyvern pick, we're just a step ahead, kind of anticipating the Tiny pick, but then we go in completely the opposite direction. S4 Zeus, one of the most feared heroes.
Crowd goes wild. Zeus comes out.
So Secret must have already have a fifth pick in mind that wasn't a Bloodseeker, because obviously that is the go-to ban when you're EG and waiting for you for the fifth pick.
It depends though. It doesn't really... I would still try to work around an IO combination. It doesn't really strive to me that it's going to be worked that well with an IO. You want to have a partner with IO here, and so far you have none. Bloodseeker IO is not really
They've played that in the past. They played the Bloodseeker IO earlier this weekend, and you know later on in the game, on the mid game, running around with a Tusk.
But don't you think that they would still miss some kind of lockdown? I wouldn't be surprised by just seeing. I mean, okay, we see the Bloodseeker ban here, but I still think their lockdown right now is not that great.
Well, I mean, that's partly your point, Jacob, right? I mean, the fact that Seeker probably are thinking of something else because the Bloodseeker was probably going to get banned.
They have something
by EG.
They have something ready and prepared. They must have realized that EG would ban out the Bloodseeker.
I mean, I feel like Secret needs physical damage here.
I mean, Tiny is an
I mean, but physical damage. Yeah, but I was thinking PA for a minute, but then against a Winter Wyvern, you can't do that.
Well. I mean, EG really has posed that question throughout the draft. I mean, saying, who are you going to pick up? I mean, you can try to save it for last, but we're going to make sure that your choices are very limited. So it's up to really Team Secret. I mean, they've done this through and through, though. They've managed to surprise both their opponents and the fans, and of course, the casters sometimes, too. So we'll see if Secret has something else up their sleeve, or if they're now going to have to rely a little bit more on just their in-game coordination and strategy once they jump into game number one.
They really are limited in their carries that they can pick, though.
We've seen them pick up on Orthodox heroes in the past. We've seen them pick up the Anti-Mage as the only team of all these top teams here at the tournament. I wouldn't put it past them to pick a Spectre.
Not too bad. It's actually...
Spectre's better than PA.
It'll have a fairly decent time farming with the Dazzle support. Tusk and IO can be anywhere on the map, and you have the global ulti from Zeus, and then the Spectre follow-up.
It's also pretty good against a Shaker.
Wow.
You just take the initiation.
Yeah, definitely. Shaker's going to have a hard time if it is. He's already gone against the Zeus and the Wisp, I feel.
I do like that EG lineup.
This EG draft is terrifying. It's just terrifying.
I don't know how you're going to kill it.
Exactly. I mean, they have so many tools to zone around the egg.
So we look at the lanes. We most likely expect a Leshrac mid here, played by Samael. Then I believe a Razor short lane off Fear. Then you have a support duo.
I think it's Aoi on the Earthshaker again.
Aoi Shaker?
Yeah, I think so. As Alan was saying on Friday, Phoenix on a fall roll is just not nice to watch.
I like it.
No, Phoenix, I assume it's Phoenix offlane. I'm just wondering between if it's Aoi playing the Shaker or if it's
PBD
playing it.
Oh, okay. We agree on the supporters.
Yes. Right
on. It'll be PBD Wyvern and Aoi Shaker if they go that route, probably.
All right. Well, Secret kind of pushed into the corner here already in game one in the drafting phase. PBD trying to pressure them.
I felt like they need some burst, but...
You get caught in the purse.
Do you think it's that great?
No.
With a Zeus?
I would have preferred the Tiny then.
Zeus gives you vision, so you have a relocate factor, but...
Secret's got a window. They got to play this perfectly.
Yeah, well, maybe they can. I mean, that's sometimes what they rely on. They just draft what they have left, and they're like, hey, we can still beat you because we can play that perfect game. We'll find out. Game number one of the Grand Finals, the Best of Five, is about to begin. We have some excellent voices to bring you the action, so the casters on the stage will take it away to kick the finals off.
Thank you very much. Yes, it is grand final time. I'm Tubby One, joined by the Capitalist, and we'll take you through what could be one thrilling best of five series in one of the greatest locations here in Europe, Commerzbank Arena, ESL One Finals, EG, their second time appearing here, but no 22-0.
You couldn't ask for a better venue, and in my opinion, better teams to face up against in the finals. I mean, Evil Geniuses and Secret have a storied past back and forth. They've met in multiple finals, in multiple LAN events, and have series that have gone either way, right? And this makes this final, right before we go into TI, all the more important for one of these teams to establish dominance as basically the top team in the world right now. That's what we're looking at here.
Yep, it's fantastic teams. We've got a small little problem with the players. We'll get this sorted out ASAP. For them, everything has to be absolutely perfect for EG as well as Secret. But luckily, the ESL crew, they've been working hard throughout the entire weekend. And of course, while it might have actually started to start raining, it's not going to dampen our spirits for this game. Not only have we been here the entire time, this absolutely wonderful crowd here in Frankfurt has also been here, sticking with us through thick and thin. And have got themselves to have the grand final, which a lot of people were expecting. They were expecting EG versus Secret. It's exactly what they got.
This crowd has been amazing, by the way. I mean, just hearing the roar of the crowd every single time we see one of those big plays, man. I've actually talked to a couple of people who are completely new to Dota, and they've just been blown away by the atmosphere here of everyone getting so excited over seeing top two teams like this playing up against each other. Evil Geniuses. So, Toby, I don't know about you, but I have been feeling very torn on this finals. People kept asking me, okay, who do you got for the finals? Who's going to win the finals? And I kept responding with a different answer every single time because I couldn't decide. I kept telling them, you know what, my heart is for EG, but my head is for Secret. You know, I just feel like EG, this is their chance to be able to finally take a first place finish after, you know, it's been a while since we've seen them do that. Meanwhile, Secret have been looking really strong. I mean, their series up against IG was impressive. Is all hell.
Yeah, man, they've been playing amazingly. Secret can basically do anything they want to, when they want to, and how they want to. They don't care what the meta is, they'll make their own. While EG, while they might loosely stick to the meta, for them, their timing, their rotations, PPD and Albi, their combination together is wonderful to watch. Universe on the offlane having a lot more of an impact in this competition than I've been seeing him have in previous competitions. And of course, the boy wonder, Samael. He has been absolutely unstoppable. His two performances during the semi-final, I don't think you'll see a better example of how a mid can walk over a team. Both teams have so much to play for, and at this point, Cap, I'm going to say I'm massively biased towards good Dota 2. These guys are going to play awesome Dota, and we're just going to be rewarded for a full best of five. The more games we have, the greater it will be.
What a cop-out. So you're not going to side with either one of these teams, are you? You're not
going to
make
a...
All right, well, I feel like Secret's... Looking at just this draft, I feel like Evil Geniuses are going to take game one. I really like the EG lineup, and I think Hans, I think, was the first person to say, you know, Secret are put on a timer here, and they got to close out the game pretty early. They need to be able to play this game pretty perfectly, essentially, because you've got a lot of problems potentially for our Sven. Sven is a really great physical damage carry, especially when coupled up with the Wisp, that is able to burst down heroes really quickly with his insane amount of physical damage. It's good versus certain cores such as Leshrac, who are relatively squishy and can output a large amount of damage over time. But then you look at certain carries like Razor, who are sort of the antithesis to the Sven. Excellent at being able to kite around melee heroes. Not so much with the Wisp, but still, it is a factor. And of course, being able to drain away that Sven's damage via Static Link is going to be a big factor as well. So the Sven is going to have some issues. Maybe he can clear through some mail pretty quickly, but Fear is still going to be his nemesis.
You're 100% right, man. So it's all about bad positioning for Secret. The supports will have to do a hell of a lot of work, but our laning phase is already underway. So up on top is PPD and Universe. Rainer's dual combo, but Universe, the first stun, it's just harassment, nothing much more than that. But then again, with Kuro and Puppy being tethered together, Universe is forced to Icarus dive away down to 51 HP. And PPD just puts a stopper on the lane with a Fissure. He needs to hold this creep wave at bay so Universe can find his level two. And of course, be a little bit safer near that tower now that Icarus dive is on cooldown.
Yeah, I was going to say, as I was watching the draft, I love the Phoenix last pick. I feel it really tied together the Evil Geniuses lineup quite well. And I love it paired up with a Phoenix. I mean, first of all, just the laning phase is so much better for a Phoenix if you're able to get just a couple of Fissure blocks and move the creep wave equilibrium to the Phoenix's favor so it can pick up level two, maybe even level three. But notice what Secret are doing. They are doing an incredibly good job at controlling this equilibrium. Despite the blocks of the Fissures, they've managed to still keep the lane pushing into their tower.
Speaking of Fissure as well, notice PPD's rotation. He walked up on top of the little stairwell just north of the mid lane. It's just in this little stairwell up here, a little bit further north. And he was waiting for the opening to actually have a crack at S4. But the Dire Observer wards from Secret are so perfectly placed. One watching the top ward area and the rotation down from top, which is where they knew the Earthshaker would start. And then the second one on S4's side of the lane, so he can keep tabs on this. And that'll allow him to see if Earthshaker's trying to throw one from the other side. Kuro and Universe just trading blows. No one should be able to find any kill on either of them here. But just making sure that this Zeus, who is very easy to gank, cannot be ganked by the Earthshaker Fissure block, because he will die very quickly. The slow, the split Earth from the Shrek, he's got his own setup up against the Zeus.
Yeah, they need a very aggressive, like, I really love the mid ward in particular, because this allows them to be able to see over onto the Radiant side of the mid lane and see the potential Earthshaker rotating over. I mean, Fissure is such a long range initiation that just that one long range stun, even from the Radiant side, could catch out the Zeus, and then the follow-up split Earth and Lightning could be enough to overwhelm the Zeus. So the warding is really well done by Secret here, playing very much into what Evil Geniuses want to run here. PPD is now going to be forced to try and do constant pulling while AUI continually forces out Zai.
And Zai's had a real hard time down here. Only 2 CS. You're talking about him being forced out. Like, Zai's only just TP'd back, and he's using shards to farm up the lane. But when this happens from Fear, you're Static Link, force him back underneath the tower. Life is just hard, but not as hard as it is for Universe, who still hasn't managed to crack his second level and is being zoned out really by one S4, trouble in middle. Kuro gonna tether himself in, but then again, S4 wants to have a crack at this fighting boss still on cooldown. Oh, really low to fail. He's gonna go down. S4, owie. He can't reach him in time, so S4 will survive. Kuro, right place, right time, and right Dota channel. They may even go for more. The crazy thing is, with this dual combo, they're able to share each other's bottles through the tether. And that means they can keep the pressure on Kuro, even chasing Universe far into the top lane.
Yeah, Samael, I think he realized that, okay, with the Wisp Tether, they're going to be able to dive me, and he just tries and turns, and maybe just didn't realize he wasn't going to be able to output enough damage. Also, there was the Winter Wyvern who was going to coming in, who could have potentially gotten off a save via the Cold Embrace, but unfortunately, AUI was just a second too late, and now is going to be forced back as S4 and Kuro take control of that four-minute room.
Yeah. Which means instant life, instant mana for both heroes as they share their own fate. Want to keep a very close eye as well on Arteezy, because while all this is going on, EG's attention is being dragged towards the middle lane. While Arteezy is getting more and more space, I'm seeing him with the boots and the gloves so far. I'm wondering if this is going to be the early Midas for Arteezy.
Oh, the rotation's coming out. The split Earth misses, and Zai is hoping to be able to get
the kill. Oh! Caught! The Fissure might be able to block him enough time. They embrace Samael, but S4's waiting. One more second on that Lightning Bolt. Zai's already dropping low for the Lightning Bolt. The Arc Lightning! S4's able to get the kill over Lashrak, but it's tip for tap. With also that Tuskar going down, they continue to chase Aoi, who goes onto his hovels to try and run back to base. He'll survive while Fear chasing up the Puppy on the bottom lane. He's got traits, got the movement speed on Puppy with a plasma field. The damage, not enough. He realizes Shallow Grave still available for Puppy. It's not easy to find that kill. And the TP in from Zai, maybe he can shard up and hold Fear close in the tower. That looks like he's not going to give it a shot. Not while the Radiant Creep Wave is still in force. Middle lane, S4, stun on him. There's a Fissure from PPD to set up, and Samael just makes it look easy with the Lightning Bolt.
Two deaths on Sumail, but if they can get a couple more kills on, just this one pickoff on Zeus helps Sumail out in an incredible amount. I mean, being able to bring in that experience for the Leshrac is a serious factor. Obviously, he needs a lot of gold, but levels mean so much. The faster he gets to that level 8, has the maxed out Split Earth and Lightning Storm, he is a significant force that can pretty much pop almost any hero in this game. If you lead with the Fisher, you follow up on anybody else, you're going to be able to kill them, except for maybe the Sven.
Top lane, goes for it, Godstrike, that's not enough damage to kill him. Universe down to 25 HP. Don't know if calculated or just lucky.
Poor Universe, man. They are putting so much pressure.
Again, the Fisher. This time, though, the Leshrac don't come follow in time. And in fact...
Yeah, there it is.
Rando kill on top. Not really Rando. S4, less the Thunder God's Wrath rip. Meanwhile, Aoi on bottom lane. Okay, he's just embracing himself to hold Zai back.
I think that's exactly why PPD was really trying to force that kill there in the middle lane in order to try and stop S4 from picking up his level 6, because there wasn't anything Universe can do there. He was brought to 20 HP and had to run himself back to the fountain. Of course, the moment that S4 hits that level 6, he's going to pop his ultimate for the kill.
And that means an easy one. 3-for-1 on S4. Sumail and PPD again thinking about it for Kuro in the neighborhood. Going to spread out the balls and try and have a crack into Sumail. But the Fissure will keep S4 at bay for now. But they've still got 4 more bottle charges between the two of them. So they're perfectly alright, Kuro and S4 going for this. And in fact, the extra TP support's gonna come in. There's no vision from the Radiant side in this area. And in fact, they actually use Zai to refresh up both of the bottles. In fact, Zai, now with a shard of Sumail, they snowball in. Sumail's in trouble, but not dead yet. The pulse Nova ripping through Zai's life. Kuro's keeping him alive from down in the river. And then maybe they can actually turn this EG right behind on the S4. But Fear, Plasma Fear, the damage is not enough to kill off Zeus. Kuro kept Zai alive most of the time in the shards. It keeps Fear out. They couldn't face the situation. Was down at S4. He took it the high ground. 11 seconds to Thunder God's Wrath. If they can get one more lightning bolt into Fear, or maybe just the Whisper of Balls. Fear is critical. Can they get it off? 3 seconds, 2 seconds. The salve will keep Fear alive. So it will not be enough damage from S4 to find that kill.
Incredibly well played by Secret. They are dealing with these rotations.
Oh, Kuro. Lightning bolt. They go for the arc as well. Trying to have another crack over on Fear.
Unfortunately, the rotations from the Winter Wyvern can't actually save that well. I mean, the Cold Embrace is a minor amount of healing, but it's percentage-based. This early on to the game, it dwarfs in comparison to the raw magic damage that is being output by the Zeus.
I got my answer for Arteezy. It looks like we're rushing up into a BKB at this point, as we have the Ogre Club as well as the Power Treads. He's been triggering his God Strength every time he can to try and force down this Tier 1 tower on the top lane. Currently brought it down to half of its life. And this is also keeping EG with their eyes on the top lane, because they're worried if they leave it for too long, Arteezy's just going to cleave through it all.
Yeah, now movement speed is pretty critical here for the Sven, so the SNY is also an option. Just being able to stay ahead or keep up with the Razor is a very critical factor. Coupled with the Tether, you can pretty much get to max movement speed, then you throw out the Warcry and 522 is there, right? So SNY is a potential option as well. BKB may be a necessity, though, just because there's so much magic damage from EG.
Yeah, that's what I was worried about, not to mention the long-range control stuns. But then again, if you throw out the Fission, you're still going to walk around it and you burn like 3-4 seconds worth of your BKB time just walking around a rock wall. It's not the kind of landscaping you really had in mind.
The big question for me is, what are they going to do with Universe? The Phoenix is a very special offlane in the fact that he can do so much in the mid game if he's just able to get levels, but it's so hard for him to make the laning phase work oftentimes. Universe got caught in this sort of trap where he's facing up against really good supports who are playing it well, and the supports actually got an experience advantage over this Phoenix and were able to just man up against him every single time. The Phoenix couldn't fight against that, couldn't push back against the support, so every single time he felt pressure, he was the one who wilted first. So he didn't get any experience out of this lane, and he still doesn't have his level 6. He's pretty much a non-factor at this point, Toby. The last time we saw him was in that middle lane fight where his Fire Spirit's damage was so minimal that it was actually being outdone by the healing of Kuro.
Well, one of the options he will have is once you see this Razor finish up mech, that Fear's probably going to group up with the rest of EG. It could be with Leshrac as well, or they could just try and do like a 3-1-1, but that will allow the Phoenix to move down to the bottom lane. Then Universe gets his time to hit level 6, then maybe he'll join the fights. But it's the time to farm, it's the time to play catch up, while the rest of his team potentially
unless they find themselves in team fights, because they don't really want that. What they kind of want is just to force Secret's hand to always be looking where EG is moving, because that was one thing which Secret has already shown very well today during the semi-finals. They know how to efficiently move across the map and come up with a better trace. Now middle lane, Lightning, follow-up stun, S4's in real trouble, the Pulse Nova, Kuro could not keep him alive. And that's just a good kill from EG.
Yeah, I believe Kuro even cut his tether half a second before we see our Zeus end up going down, because he realized, okay, there's no way it can save him, and I don't want to be too close to that Leshrac. So that was a smart move by Kuro and EG, another well-executed gank, especially with leading Samael moving forward in order to make sure he got a good Pulse Nova range.
Well, Arteezy's finished his next item. We won't see if it's Ness fly, but he does go for the max movement speed you were hoping for. It just comes with a cost, and that's through the Mask of Madness for Arteezy. He hits hard, and he hits fast.
Yeah, this is easily one of the most damage-efficient items, gold-efficient items, for a Sven to pick up, because you already have such a big damage increase through God's Strength, and your melee your movement speed is incredibly important to you, so you get the movement speed there, obviously the attack speed, just being able to get the added benefit out of that God's Strength damage increase.
Well, right time for EG, this is rapidly approaching level 6. In fact, he's only one level now behind Kuro. I'm saying that's a great thing when I'm actually comparing him to Super Seeker. But their offlaner of Tarkar is just behind level 7. So he's too far behind the rest of Secret. And mainly it's the level 6, because once you get the Nova up and running, as also the panel was saying, it's very difficult to kill off that egg. Maybe now with the Mask of Madness for Sven, they can remove it, but that means Sven's going to walk in point-blank range on the egg. It's not a simple task to do, but you got a lot of stuns and control coming in from EG.
Yeah, I think there are two things that synergize really well with the Phoenix egg. And are heroes that are able to have stuns and can actually initiate. So, for example, Lion with a Blink Dagger, or Shaker with a Blink Dagger. Those kind of heroes can provide a big disruption, provide the disables to allow the egg to go off the top, and also heroes that are relatively squishy but can out huge amounts of damage in short periods of time. So your Leshrac, your Razor, both of these heroes are heroes that you probably want to target early on into the fight, otherwise you're going to be feeling 500 damage per second from each one of them. So if they can actually draw attention onto the egg and allow the Leshrac and Razor to be able to get up and close and start dealing that Pulse Nova damage or start getting that static link damage stolen, it's going to be a hard time for Secret, even if they do kill the egg, to win the fight.
That's why Secret are grouping up. PPD just had a bit of a mission there. He's trying to check out what's happening inside the Radiant Jungle, so he left one Observer Ward behind, watching the stacks and watching when they're being farmed up. And they had another Sentry Ward just making sure there was no vision around the upper part of the river if you are going to try and flank in from the left.
It's
and
time
while
to
they
smoke.
Do that, now they smoke up.
Yeah, it's definitely time to smoke because AOI has just picked up his level 6 Winter's Curse, obviously being a pivotal ability for them to be able to have to successfully get these pickoffs on even the strongest of heroes, and that's why they rotate bottom, right? The Sven just showed himself. If they could have gotten a pickoff on him, it would have been major. Plus the Winter Wyvern, as much as it was a bit of a detriment for in the early laning phase is being a support to try and save the middle lane up against magic damage, didn't really work out too often there. It is a huge counter to the Wisp.
And this is really smart PPD. I think they've caught onto this fact because everyone is missing from the map, but then again, maybe EG haven't. They're hovering around, but they're not actually having a look in. Winter Wyvern could potentially just ice burn up, but yep, with the God Strength available and the Mask of Madness, already Secret have taken Roshan. EG coming out, the Shards cannot catch PPD out of position. In fact, Arteezy, Snowball's coming up. It's coming in from Zai. He's going after Abby. He doesn't actually get there the entire way. So they embrace him up, and Zai being kept alive with Puppy as well as Kuro, relocating
nice
him back
save.
Into the pit, keeping him alive. And this does not give EG a position to punish Secret. In fact, they may just still go in for it. They'll relocate there. They have to protect him. Raze has already popped that Eye of the Storm, and Arteezy just moves up to the high ground to ensure they don't come any further. Then again, Kuro, maybe a little bit too close. The Shards in the Sun, he's on the wrong side of it, but PPD in front line. The Fissure, Kuro so low. Owie's there, but he can't do enough damage. And Arteezy just can't reach past the Shards. They have to force off him away to safety. That's from S4. And the Shard to block the ramp. No deaths from either side. just very, very close escapes.
I mean, even when it was, like, there were so many good plays there from Secret. Getting outside of that Roshan pit, they were potentially in a bad position to get caught by Winter's Curse. So Zai, the moment he sees the Winter Wyvern, immediately pops the snowball, right? Because not only does he have the snowball to save himself, but he can potentially grab his allies mid-Winter's Curse, which is a huge counter. So he pops that, but then the Winter Wyvern backs up, and he's stuck in his position of, oh no, I'm going to go over the cliff. I'm going to be in a bad position, right? Somebody needs to save me. And that's where Secret cover their ally beautifully. And it's not just the Kuro relocate, but it's the positioning of Secret as a whole to make sure that evil geniuses couldn't take advantage of the sort of mispositioning from Zai due to the snowball that, you know, was a good idea but didn't work out as they expected.
And then, of course, Zai's follow-up, like, he just keeps shouting. When you've got such a narrow choke point, how is EG meant to move forward and play up against a hero like a Tusker if he's actually sitting in this back position? It's just great play by all. Now PPD again, like, he's hoping he can just do the basic combination now. Secret don't have vision of this. They see some mail in the mid just throwing out lightning, but that kind of means to Zai that maybe he can have a crack some mail. And he's getting caught out by the shards, but with the support right behind him, he's very, very happy to be in such a position because it means Secret may initiate over the river.
Yeah, another good amount of synergy that I don't think we've talked about just yet, but it's the Razor, who's a natural mech buyer with the Leshrac, who is a hero that obviously needs the added sustain from his allies, and if you don't actually have healers, having some sort of core that can get a mech is a huge benefit. It really synergizes well with his squishy intelligence hero. So this is actually going to play very well into the favor of evil geniuses when it comes to team fights, but I really feel like Secret just kind of outplaying
EG. See PPD, he's walking up the hill, he doesn't want to come this way. The Shards, the Fissure, he gets three with the Totem Stomp. He's got Echo Summon of Arbal 2, can't get it off in time. Puppy Shadow Wave will be able to get the kill.
Ooh, and an early four stab being picked up by S4 does help Zai get out of position there, where he was going to take a lot of damage from the Leshrac. I really like this early four stab play. I think it makes a lot of sense, particularly since we do have so many critical disables. If there's a Fissure lead in, he could save an ally from the follow-up Split Earth that's just naturally going to follow.
Mm-hmm. I was actually able to help him out too when they're fighting on that bottom rune area. Universe? Okay, this just looks too easy for RTZ. If he runs after a Universe at the moment, he's just going to end up dying because Aoi and Samael are both waiting for him. And now, a little too close. But Aoi might be holding him for the moment, but it's not going to happen.
Yeah, Samael got spotted there, and Kuro was ready to go with the relocate save as well. So, Team Secret are getting, as we're watching Team Secret, like, are playing beautifully and defending their allies and making sure that everyone does get out alive when they come down to these engagements. Secret is taking more of an advantage because EG are the ones looking for these kills, and they're just not finding the openings right now, which means Secret are getting more of an advantage through farming.
Yeah. Well, they're going to get more of an advantage with his Tier 1 town dropping as well. Universe sitting at the back lines. He still doesn't want to get involved. He wants to finish up his hand of minus before he does anything else. They're losing the Tier 1 tower, and they can keep pushing. Godstrength has not been required to be used. Now middle lane, the shards fly out. The fortifications keeping that Tier 1 tower alive for Secret. And Fear wants it, but S4 snowballed in. They with the Walrus Punch. They're trying to find the pickoff, but Fear has the mech charge. Kuro will relocate himself to Zai with a Fissure from DVD. He holds him there. The Echo Slam is not enough to keep enough space between Razor as well as the rest of Secret. But Samael comes in with a Pulse Nova, going for Poly, but the Shadow Grace making it difficult. Aoi will also arrive. Samael needs to finish the job. Finally, he will be able to do so. So it's a 2-for-1 trade-off. PPD lucky to survive. Meanwhile, on the north lane, Zven with the God Strength is taking out the Tier 2 tower.
Yeah, it does come at a very heavy cost. Kuro, though, by the way, able to relocate at the last second there, back up to the top lane in order for him to help out the Zven take that tower, but also saved his own life in the process. I think evil geniuses are not going to be happy with the kills they got, but they just didn't get enough, in my opinion, to make it worth the trade-off of that Tier 2 tower in the top lane. Arteezy is going to be massive, man. He already has that BKB plus Mask of Madness. With the Blink Dagger now being picked up, this is an incredibly aggressive build from Zven, and it's just the way I think Arteezy needed to play it for this game. They have to make sure they've taken a small advantage now. They got to build that advantage from here on out.
And with the initiation, too, like, Sven's very, very tanky when he jumps in. There's 4 points up in Warcry, so you're giving bonus 20 armor, high movement speed, the immunity which comes from your BKB, and your ability to jump point-blank range with a huge amount of damage to even one hit, but maybe 3 or 4 hit down Samael. Winter Wyvern won't survive for very long, and I would be very, very careful about PPD ever getting a stun off, because he'll get stunned himself. So they have to keep their eye open to see where Arteezy is coming. Just like now in the mid, jumped in, goes for Universe, is available, but the damage is just too much. Zeus will help out with Thunder God's Wrath. Aoi, a very quick TP in. PPD is already fairly injured as well because he got some spill damage, obviously hitting every hero with that Thunder God's Wrath.
Yeah, I mean, two heroes like
round
that.
Round two, they're going in after Smail. The God Strain still hasn't worn off, but the Embrace will keep Smail alive. They hold Sven there too, but not for long. In comes S4, Kuro.
It's not a bad idea from AEY to use that Winter's Curse on a BKB hero like that. Maybe they could have actually followed that up if there wasn't the relocate from the side. Unfortunately, AEY, his choice to do that Winter's Curse meant they didn't have anything to punish the kind of aggressive relocate play. By the way, I just want to say that Kuro's positioning of that relocate was beautiful, right? Like, he puts it aggressive, but not overly aggressive where he's in the range of the tower or potentially any of EG right away.
RT's got to get out of here. No BKB charge. PPD starts with a stomach. Blinks away just in time. They know he's in the tree line. Smail goes for the stun, hits it perfectly. Arteezy will die. Nothing can save him. God's Strength even commit the Echo Slam from PPD. A little bit of overkill.
That would have been.
They get the big one.
That would have been so impressive if he had managed to actually TP away in time. That clutch Blink Dagger timing. Now it looks like they're going to fight in middle lane already. Universe leading the charge here with the egg.
His eyes right on top of it, but he's trying to kill it off. There's PPD with a stun. The Nova's about to crack. They're not in range to get the stun, but Universe means he can come back full life. They chase after S4. There's already two down. The Shallow Grave's there, but more surprise than S4 will not survive this. PPD Hosman with a stun, but the timing goes fast. He gets time to get it off.
It is a 3-1 on the sidelines at the moment.
Still an excellent fight for Evil Geniuses, getting the pick off in this event, immediately rotating. I love the fact the Universe was sitting in the trees, waiting that one out. He's like, guys, you've gotten that kill. If you get back to middle right now, I can force this fight with the egg.
He did it perfectly. Now it goes 8-8. While it has been a low killing game, it's still been very action intense as both of the lineups coming close to each other. Just going to straight off trades. If we do look over at the map, there's only tier 2 towers left for Team Secret. While EG, well, they've lost. They've lost quite heavily too. The fact that top lane has no external towers anymore. They do, however, still hold their tier 1 tower in mid lane, which you would think in most games would give them a positional advantage. But the fact you're going up against a Wisp kind of throws that one out the window.
Yeah, especially the advantage that was lost there from Secret is particularly important when you have a build-up item like Bloodstone that was completed just before that fight. Samael has 11 Bloodstone charges already, and we've seen what Samael can do when he gets ahead of the enemy.
I'm still interested to see if you can do it up against this enemy. There's so much damage in the hands of Sven, and Arteezy just keeps farming. They're giving him as many stacks as possible. He's rapidly approaching 12,000 net worth. Smell is nipping on his heels, and at this point, Smell is obviously able to continuously do a hell of a lot of damage as long as the mana is there, while Arteezy is a little bit more tied to his God Strength until he's capable of buying up a big damage-dealing item, which more than likely in this style of game, well, you can go Monkey King Bar, you can go Daedalus, you can kind of go whatever you really want to for this Sven.
Scouting Zeus ultimate being used there to see if they can spy out if Evil Geniuses were going for a smoke tank or something, but it's simply EG playing very defensively right now. They know they've seen that Blink Dagger from Arteezy. They're a little bit afraid of getting caught out by that one. Usually when you see a Blink Dagger, this kind of build from the Sven, it means a lot of aggression, it means a lot of pickoff capabilities, and you're going to take that one kill and then immediately take his tower afterwards with a physical damage increase of God Strength. Well, Secret are actually backing up and spending a little bit more time farming, probably because of that last team fight that they lost. If they lose any more, this game's rapidly spiral out of control for them. But Evil Geniuses, the interesting player to watch here in these team fights is actually going to be the Winter Wyvern. AUI, he's positioned not only in Winter's Curse, because he's a direct counter to the Wisp, but he's also a direct counter to the Sven, where a primary source of damage is all physical. So Cold Embrace, if he's able to target the right hero at the right time, he could completely mitigate the Sven's heavy amount of net worth that he has accomplished.
Which is where then S4 has to step up to the mark, as well as the Tusker. A Tusker at this point is going more utility. We've got Mech now being completed 24 minutes into the game on the Tusk. He's walking back to base now to pick it up. And over on Zeus, the Bloodstone is rapidly approaching completion as well for S4.
You got a couple other items. Glimmer Cape being picked up by the Wisp is obviously a huge increase to the survivability of Kuro, as well as a potential save for some allies. I love Zai's build of the mech with the arcane boots. We're going to later on see Guardian Greaves, though I'm not sure how early he wants that item. Perhaps a Blink Dagger or something, some sort of saving mechanism, I think would be better before the Guardian Greaves is complete.
Samael, I thought he was about to try with the initiation on the Zai with the lightning. Wouldn't really have that much follow-up, however, the Universe would have to Icarus dive himself in with sprites. to try and get in his way to allow for the Split Earth follow-up, because it was a pretty long way across the river. How long we got until we have Roshan up? In fact, at no time. Roshan is already up and available. So this will probably be our next mark. Secret can, we've already seen they can just jump in and quickly take out Roshan. So EG have to keep their eyes open for this. Right now they've only got one Observer Ward, which is right on top of the Dire Observer Ward, but that will see anyone entering into the pit from the front end. If anyone blinks over, if they, I don't know, they snowball, but if they relocate him, then none of that will be spotted.
Well, there's the Solar Crest. They have so much Roche taking potential. Oh. Now with that minus armor item plus the physical damage from Sven.
They tether in, they smoke in, and the Dire have
no
Radiant have no vision of this whatsoever. In fact, even S4, he's found that small little point where the ward doesn't see up to, and that Roshan is dead very, very quickly.
Oh yeah, they have no vision and no time to be able to get there in order to stop Secret. So a secondary Roshan going their way. Evil Geniuses, I think, expect this. Even if they didn't know Roshan was up right now, they kind of expect Secret to be able to snag this one. I mean, currently, EG want to play on their side of the map. They don't want to move outside of these towers. They don't want to get picked off. So they're still trying to complete some of those basic team fight items, such as the Aghanims on Razor.
And that Aghanims on Razor is going to arrive, but I would also ask the big question, how much work is it really going to be doing? Because I'm looking at a lot of armor, which is now starting to arrive for Secret. Artizi has practically finished. In fact, yeah, basically has finished up his full assault cuirass. Now he farms up this camp. Mm-hmm. And then you've also got the Weave coming in from Dazzle, who's already up at level 11. So you've got a level 2 Weave available for Secret. Their armor is going to pop through the roof during these fights.
I love Samael's build. This is Samael through and through, right? Samael's a very talented mechanical player who loves to be able to outplay his opponents, right? And we saw it with the SF in that earlier series where he picked up a kind of a little bit of a later Blink Dagger. Sometimes you would see SFs go for a little bit more of a late game build, but Samael fully adopting the mid game aggression and goes for the Blink Dagger, and he utilized it beautifully to win several fights, and he's going to try and do something similar here. Backed up by the Yule Scepter, this also means he could have some potential saves for himself against the initiation of Secret.
EG understand where Secret are moving. There's a Radiant Ward just sitting in the lower part of the mid-river, and I was able to scout up this Ven moving into the Radiant Jungle. Now that also Puppy shows himself on the bottom lane with that Solar Crest, he's just flagging the fact that most of Secret are down there, while Wisp, it's just the illusions which will chase, and you're hoping they don't commit anything major to this. In fact, yeah, they won't. It's just a basic attack. Samael blinks up and gets rid of it so they can get rid of the vision at least. And then EG, do they defend this bottom tower? Puppy, you've got a Dazzle harassing down a bottom tower. You have to do something about this.
All right, they must know a little bit more than they let on. Evil Genius
just actually cut off these heroes bottom. Puppy already getting stunned up. At the same time, Zai being controlled up by Fear, already on 112 points of damage. Icarus dive in, Circle, the only thing that can protect him, while Arteezy chasing after Aoi, two hits to bring him down. At the same time, Fear, so much stolen damage, 224 points of it. He can carve apart most of the Secret team. He's already managed to take two with him, and now can move over to Arteezy. No BKB, still has the Aegis, but controlled up by the Fissure. They'll burn through him. The plaza field goes down, and Fear's gonna be ready, or is he?
He doesn't have BKB.
Wait for the stun. The Echo slams up as well. They just hit into Sven. They take away his damage. Koro, there's no relocate up to save him, but he just keeps with that overcharge going. Puppy behind him, letting off that heal, but again, another Fissure stun to slow it down. Plaza field on the edge of Sven. Koro's doing all the work he possibly can to keep Arteezy alive, and it is enough.
Arteezy has more HP than EG has mana. They simply ran out of steam. The Leshrac ran out of mana. PB used his last Fissure there. Even Fear, his ultimate ran out, and he didn't have much more to go on. That was just beautiful healing from Kuro, and ultimately, another solid play from Secret, being able to stay alive through the initiation of EG. It seems like Secret are very adept at being able to address whenever evil geniuses go for a gank or go for some sort of smoked out team fight. Secret are very quick on the mark to be able to respond to it.
I want to see if Sumel has a crack at mid. This Dire Observer Ward from Secret's about to time out. It's only got 3 seconds left in that mid lane. And once it times out, the Blink Dagger which Samael has picked up to go with his Yule Scepter is just going to be too easy to find out. In fact, yeah, there's that scouting Zeus Thunder God's Wrath again. He really wants to know where EG is so Secret can get the best positioning and still find the maximum amount of farmers possible on the map. So no one's in the Radiant Jungle. Instantly, Arteezy heads there.
Yeah, PBD is now going to try and take some time to finish up his Blink Dagger. Hopefully he doesn't get caught by the rotation of Arteezy, though.
The Observer Ward sees him.
Yep.
No more joy.
No more joy indeed. PPD, oh, he's so close to it. Just needs another 200 gold.
He's thinking about Fissure to farm it. He can take two Creep Hits if he uses it now. But we'll require the Sun.
The relocate up to top lane. Looks like some mail coming in with that Haste Rune provoked a very defensive response from Secret.
Well, do they know where he is? In fact, they're pinging out saying, I think the, some mail. In fact, TP's down the bottom lane to try and blink forward. The Yulsep is on cooldown, but he can see Kuro. They just run away. Warcry to pop. In fact, they can't see him. The Dire Sentry Ward's down there. There's no Observer Wards for the Radiant side apart from the one on the right. So I didn't actually see Kuro leave.
Yeah, that's a nice defensive factor of the Blink Dagger. When you relocate in, you come back. From that relocate, you can instantly blink on the Sven and then go ahead and tether away on the Wisp. Very nice combination. 30 minutes in, and it's a dead even 10-10, with Secret taking a slight lead in both gold as well as experience. Evil Geniuses, though, do have some big items that they finished or are going to be finishing soon. We talked about the Aghanims on Fear. Obviously, some mail is host to a swarm of items, the Bloodstone, Yules, and Blink Dagger. And he's already got another 3K, so we can afford to build up even more stats. Now, armor wouldn't be a bad idea necessarily against the Sven damage, but you can also depend on just the cold embrace. So maybe he goes for some just more raw stats with something like an Octarine Core, which would benefit quite highly. If you manage to get a embrace there on the Leshrac, who has Pulse Nova out, he's not only healing up, he's defending against physical damage, but he's also getting that spell steal.
Yeah, everything looks kind of nice for that kind of thing, but okay, well, there's your plate mail.
Yep, so going to the Shivas, I don't mind this at all. Obviously, the physical damage from the Sven is the scariest part of Secret right now.
Another Thunder God's Wrath being used by Secret before the fight's going to begin. And EG might feel like they got a little bit of a window of opportunity where that damage won't do as much. In fact, Fear getting up in the faces of Secret underneath their own Tier 2 tower. And Samael with the Edict is just burning through the Tier 2 fortification. Secret, okay, well, they burnt it, but they burnt it late, which means there is actually no defense on that Tier 2 tower. And it's very easy for EG to keep going when they try and push the next time.
Yeah, I mean, the Zeus showing himself in that top lane via the Boots of Trammel coming in and trying to push down that lane. There's no tier two there, right? So Evil Geniuses say, go ahead, you can push it all the way to the base. You're not going to be here to defend that middle tier two, so we can easily take it with the Aghanim's upgrade of Eye of the Storm and get themselves that extra bit of gold, which is going to almost even out this lead. I mean, 5,000 at 32 minutes is not that big of a lead for Team Secret. And let's not forget that most of their net worth is centered on just one hero. That's Arteezy, which a melee carry.
Puppy's dead. Puppy is most definitely dead. Where PPD he? Blinks. He's looking for the Fissure. She's out of range. Now he walks just a couple of inches further to get in range. Alone, is that a game for Fear? They might be coming in. Oh, and he goes out. So Kuro will leave, but you've kind of just sacrificed a Dazzle for a Wisp. You're going to give him armor, and potentially with Glimmer Cape movement, Kuro could get out. In fact, they're going to Shallow Grave him, and maybe, can he TP? He was thinking about it, but tether away over the Creep Wave, just keeps running. Kuro, 22 HP. Oh, the it's following him up, but the Air Titans have got him. Almost next level escape.
Look to middle lane. He just bought a lot of time there where Arteezy is going to get, what, two, three hits in on that tier two tower with God Strength popped. That's a decent amount of chip that Kuro's just bought his team that excellent play.
They're getting the hell out of there now. But yeah, Kuro, Puppy gave him everything he possibly could. The armor, the Shallow Grave, the Creep Wave was coming at the right time so he could tether himself out if he could just buy himself a couple of seconds. And I kind of showed you, that's how much effort you got to do to bring down a Wisp. What do you do when he's tethering over to a Sven and giving that same level of heal and potential escape to him? Mm-hmm. How is EG meant to find the deeps to kill him off? Like, the Shiva's guards up with a little track. Okay, that's fantastic. Yeah, a little bit more control, a little bit more survivability. Does Fear actually have to go in? I know I mentioned it before, but do you try and go for the refresher orb just to find the damage, or do you go a different angle thinking, I have to survive long enough that maybe I can get well, I'm not going to say a second ulti off, but something.
I think you need a secondary armor item, so I wouldn't mind the Assault Cuirass being picked up for the Razor, and then you have the Shivas from the Leshrac, right?
You've got
the two armor items. I think that makes the most amount of sense. You consider the refresher later on into the game, perhaps.
Well, he bought the Hyperstone as well as the Blade Mail, so it will in fact be the Assault Cuirass. While the full Daedalus is now completed over on Arteezy, this guy's cracked over 20k net worth, and the damage output is, I'm not saying becoming ridiculous, but it's definitely getting up there.
Look at that cute little Fisher block actually keeping the Kreeze from hitting that tier 2 tower. And Samael's already taken the tier 2 at top lane, as long as he doesn't get caught. But look what Zai's doing.
Yeah, he's snowballing in, saddled with the Glimmer Cape. Support, relocate. Cora's bringing in Arteezy, but the Eurceptor up. Blink Dagger's off cooldown, but Samael can't get out in time and, in fact, will deny himself in front of the relocating secret.
Good deny. In fact, I'm a little bit surprised he didn't deny immediately when he came down. Oh, secret. Just unfortunately, timing not playing into their favor here.
48 seconds too early. We're actually getting a second Shiva's.
Yeah. I mean, double Shiva's, it's like the Leshrac needs, he feels like he needs some sort of armor item, right? And double Shiva's is not necessarily the worst thing in the world. Just being able to have that armor item on the Leshrac, I think, means a lot. He's obviously not going to go for the Assault Cuirass that's saved for the Razor, so he goes for the Shiva's, and obviously Shiva's is a natural core item for a Phoenix as well.
Well, it's just the double up, but it's fine. Looks like Dazzle's also getting a little bit more money. We've got a VIP booster over now on Puppy to go with his Solar Crest. It's a very difficult to kill off Dazzle, not to mention what that item's going to be going into next. But the one thing which is not surviving is, in fact, S4. He's down to 6 Bloodstone charges on this Zeus. It hasn't really been his game so far. 5-4-4.
He's been doing a lot of split pushing out of his Zeus. With the early Boots of Travel pickup, he has actually been keeping both the top and bottom lane consistently pushed in. The Bloodstone is still giving him enough mana regen for him to spam out Arc Lightning with impunity. And ultimates occasionally just to be able to spam out evil geniuses just like that.
Mm-hmm. I think it's about time Arteezy picked up that double damage rune from down the river. Kuro's already got himself a bounty inside of his bottle. It took another minute and a half before he has to pick it up, but if they can find an opening target, Arteezy just got to work on it. I know the crowd is already getting a little bit excited about the fact he can basically one-hit an Ancient's back.
Oh my god, they're actually going to try and solo Roshan. Look at that damage!
This is actually a relocate Roshan play, and it catches EG out of guards here. They can't even get there in time. Maybe they can clean up one or two heroes.
Oh, they lost the Wisp, which means Arteezy is stuck here, but he blinks up. Evasive Fissure of PPD. Samael goes in right now for the Tusker. The Eurceptor set up into the follow-up stun. Zai does have Glimmer Cape as well as Cheese. Snowball for protection. He needs a target to come out to. Potentially just Glimmer and Cheese, and he goes down to Aoi. No Cheese being used, no Glimmer. He'll just accept the fate. But meanwhile, Arteezy with the back of this double damage rune still has God Strength, and there is no there is a fortification to save him. Kuro, Shallow Grave, Samael's just chasing him down. Now the Yule Scepter. Kuro refuses to die. Now he will back in towards middle lane. Arteezy, a long way down.
Nice,
the four star
down
from SFL. We'll bring him up for Samael. Turns on the Pulse Nova. Arteezy turns for the stun. He's got two locks here. Where's your cleave? Universe, one more swing, can't get it off. He's in trouble, moving over towards Fear, because Universe was put under. The Aegis Demon will trigger him. There's no help coming to Arteezy. They burn him with a Sun Ray, and this is not a tan he asked for. He's going to go down. Evil geniuses defending Seeker as they aggressively push into their Tier 2 tower. That's a big kill as well. Leshrac got almost 500 gold from that kill.
So,
and he shared it with
plays.
Three allies as well.
So many clutch plays being pulled out by evil geniuses, and it all starts off with that very aggressive relocate Roshan play. Very few times will you see that, because most of the time you just don't have the physical damage necessary. I mean, everyone sees that relocate ping, right? So you're just telling everyone, hey, we're doing Roshan, but we expect to take it so quickly you won't be able to get there in time. Evil geniuses, though, I was going to say, before that whole entire thing happened, both teams know Roshan is up. Secret spotted it out earlier, and it wasn't there, and it was getting later into the timer anyway. Both teams knew Roshan was going to be up. That was the opportunity for both teams to smoke up and go for the gank. EG did that, but Secret made that very ballsy maneuver that obviously didn't play into their favor.
The hilarious thing is, it was the play after which kind of like tilted the odds.
Yeah.
Like, after you had that blink away, Secret could have just got themselves out scot-free.
Mm-hmm.
But when you're walking around as this event with so much damage and just the confidence of having Kuro behind you, like, you don't blame him for trying to force out the Tier 2 tower, but you have to remember, EG will be there in Winter Wyvern. Is it a fantastic cure for trying to like just play around with it? Not to mention the fact that Leshrac is very, very farmed up. At the same time, I'm also seeing Puppy now with a full Rod of Atos on this Dazzle. Control factors are just coming through the roof for Secret. Everyone's got a little bit of everything, and S4's also got 3.7k gold on this Zeus. I'm interested to see where he wants to put this money. Is it the Ags? Is it more of a control item? Do you try and go for a Sight Device up against someone on EG? Because you don't have a BKB on Fear. He did not go for the immunity.
The Scythe of Ice would be a little bit better if maybe he had a Blink Dagger. Instead, he's got the Force Staff, right? So he doesn't have that full Blink in instant stun.
Oh, they're coming. Smoke. Where's the jump? S4 sitting on the back line. They got Zrath gets in the vision. PPD. One hit from RTG with a Stormball combo. They move over to Fear. And Static Link, while it is currently on RTG, they just turn around. The Nova drops. They need to get their fists up. But then again, you Stormball in Tifa. And she's stopping RTG. The stun from Fear. Maybe you'll be there. It's a mail up in the air. S4 up the side for the chasing puppy into the tier 2 tower with a pulse Nova puppy. Shadow Grave will protect him and they will dive up for him. Puppy, it isn't going to last forever. Now he'll go down. Four loss from Secret. EG only losing their captain, who was the first casualty of that fight. And they even curse up the melee creep so it can keep pushing.
Again, the synergy with the Evil Geniuses lineup. This is why Secret need to play aggressive early on. This is why they had to play near perfect, because they need to be able to end the game before you see the synergy in team fights that Evil Geniuses are revealing every single time. Razor, Static linking up a Sven, and then you embrace him. So the Sven can't even hit Fear. He ends up losing 224 damage in the process of all that. The combination of both Embrace as well as Winter's Curse keeping him near the Razor, but unable to do anything to him.
And exactly what EG wanted. They force into the tier 3 tower, they chip it down to 2/3 of his life, and they get the buyback out from Sven. That's what they were hoping for, and that's exactly what they got. They also had a buyback from the Tusker. So this money is being expended by Secret, and you're gonna see a very, very drastic change in that net worth graph. It just goes straight up by almost 10,000 net worth within the space of 3 or 4 minutes. It hasn't been long, and the experience is almost jumping up further than that.
Veil of Discord even now being picked up by Universe. This is going to help out the Leshrac's damage immensely. And by the way, the Leshrac is not going to die anytime soon. He's got 16 Bloodstone charges, tons of mana to expend, but he's also finished up the Octarine Core. As we mentioned earlier, with the Embrace available to him, plus a large amount of control from both the Winter Wyvern as well as the Earthshaker, even the Egg being an obvious target for Secret a lot of the time, Samael may not feel much pressure at all, so he can play very aggressively into the enemy team with that Pulse Nova, start getting that Spell Steal, and the Octarine Core with Pulse Nova is insane if you're hitting 5 heroes with it.
Thunder God's Wrath to scout out all 5 heroes of EG moving down the mid. This isn't for a smoke gang, this is literally just to walk together straight down the mid lane.
Oh, and why not? I mean, they're in such a great position. Zeus S4 actually going for the Dagon with the gold that he grabs. So trying to get that extra bit of burst damage, I can understand it. They need to try and finish up the Evil Geniuses heroes quickly before Pulse Nova, Static Link, these sort of big damage over time abilities are going to work. I'm not sure how they're going to be able to find the correct initiation unless somehow RTZ managed to find a Blink In and a multiple hero Storm Hammer. I don't see how they're going to win the fights.
For now, right now, Arteezy just wants to keep the top lane pushed out. That's the primary goal. Samael just also BT'd himself down to the bottom lane, so there's a little bit more space for Arteezy just to force EG back. Secret had perfect vision. In fact, they even saw the ward which EG planted, which now Puppy is coming up here to T-ward. They used the lightning bolt to get rid of it. So the vision from EG is not really that terrific inside the Radiant jungle, especially as S4 finds the second ward too. So EG, as far as vision on the Radiant side, on the Dire side of the map, they've only got one ward on the bottom lane. The rest of it's down to the creep wave and their hero positions.
Yeah, and this is, I want to point out another reason that the pressure was on Secret to try and take this early, because look at Evil Geniuses, they actually have 2 percentage-based heals. The Phoenix's Sunray, which is now maxed out, is based on the Phoenix's HP and damage as well as heal. And then you've got the heal coming out from the Cold Embrace as well, which is, again, percentage-based. So as time goes on, this is actually going to scale very efficiently for Evil Geniuses.
You can watch for their effects as we go into our next fight in a moment. Looks like the line on the box has been drawn by Puppy. Wants to check out and see what's happening just around their ancient area. Roshan's still another 1 minute away from potential spawn time. We've seen how quickly that can go down. Where's S4? He's going to actually scout on top of the hillside, but that's not where the Radiant Observer Ward is. EG is being a lot more clever. In fact, they're pinging out where they think it is, and yep, S4. No, he's actually... He threw 2 lightning bolts and actually missed the ward, which means EG still have perfect vision of Secret, but Secret will probably feel very comfortable that there's no vision there.
Evil Geniuses wanting to wait out this next Roshan. again, they have so much value. If they're able to get that Aegis, first of all, Leshrac is probably one of the better heroes to get an Aegis, and then she's also being picked up by whether it's a Leshrac or the Razor. Like, it's a lot of value there as well. So this is something that Secret cannot allow in any stroke of the imagination. They have to go for some sort of pick off or fight and then claim Roshan for themselves. That's their best play to be able to still win this game one.
Well, I'll be waiting a while, man. Roshan will not spawn until we hit roughly the 47-minute mark. So they've got some time for this. The rest of the time, just commit to farm. What do you actually want to see Arteezy go next? Like, you got the BKB, you could drop the TP scroll and pick up one other big item. Is it just always Aegis on the back of this Ven? Or do you say, you know what, we can keep him alive, do we go for something else? We go for like a Monkey King, but you go for extra damage on this Ven.
I mean, there's no evasion just yet on the side of Evil Geniuses, so an MKB is not a necessity. But I am actually not sure what his best damage item is at this point. I honestly just don't see a better way. He's just going to be kited more and more often as time goes on. His four stats, these veils are being picked up. Like, there's so many factors that EG can grab these sort of utility items to try and kite around the Sven. And then there's the natural synergy of Evil Geniuses line up against that Sven as well. So I honestly think that he has to go some sort of, like, in my opinion, Toby, let's go Divine Rapier. I mean, let's just go in all-in item and try and win that one team fight through one or two hits that manage to pop a critical, eliminate a hero immediately on the onset of a fight, and try and snowball that from there. I don't see how he's going to be able to win these fights without some sort of critical all-in item like that.
That's a very, like, all-in is the word. If you end up losing that and giving it over to basically anyone on the EG lineup, you are running the risk of just throwing away game number one of this best of five grand final.
Honestly, Toby, I look at E-Secret at the position where they have to make some sort of dire circumstances sort of rush. But the most likely option, in my opinion, would be Abyssal Blade. I think he does need the extra lockdown. It'd be huge damage increase.
I'm down for that. Bottom lane, Puppy trying to run out of here. He goes into the tree line. Can Shellograven TP out? The sun's already gone. Maybe he can give it a shot. No, the damage, the Fissure is there. That's what they require. The secondary stun. But that's fine for them. S4 was still capable of escaping. And you might be down a Dazzle for 60 seconds, but he's got buyback and is a support for Secret. They're okay with this, as long as Roshan doesn't spawn up. But hey, the big man is up.
Another really efficient item for this Ven is actually Heart, because he is a strength hero, and obviously the natural amount of strength you pick up from a Heart is very efficient for him, because when you increase your stats, obviously, you get a big benefit out of God's Strength, which is why that Ven is probably one of the most common carries to go for a Heart going into the late game. But again, I'm just not sure that without the control offered by Abyssal or an incredibly high amount of damage, that Ven's going to be able to win these fights. Is he's kind of not doing it so low, but he's backed up by just a bit of magic damage from Zeus, and that's kind of it.
You hit the mark perfectly, man. It really has to be the Abyssal Blade. Hold him in position and then just beat the crap out of him. And you're only going to need maybe one or two hits. The four stars will cause you problems. Now the fact we see an Eye of Skadi also over on the Razor, you're going to be slowed inside your own BKB. Dude, this is really problematic for him. And Roshan, how fast can it be done? In fact, is Secret even... Yeah, actually, it's not being done fast at all. This isn't Secret doing it, it's EG doing it now, and their damage against Roshan is quite minimal. In fact, Arteezy triggers the God Strength. They want to come in through the top. Fortification will have to be popped, while S4 is adding pressure onto the Tier 2 tower, and EG, they are coming back. Kuro just wants to run away. The Glimmer Cape is up, so our PPD and Universe don't see where they are. They run straight back up lane, and Zai, with this fresh Blink it's Dagger, relocates the Nail. It's going to go for the stun. They relocate in for Roshan, and the damage from Arteezy is so intense. Exactly. Roshan's already down, and the cheese will also fall into their hands. They've actually got two cheese now, one on Puppy and one over on Zyme.
You could see exactly what Secret were doing there, right? The moment you bait TPs up to the top lane, they know Evil Geniuses are not going to take Roshan that fast. The moment they bait TPs up to the top lane, all they have to do is back Smail far enough away.
Whoa, Smail blinking in, going to go for the full ops on Koro, but actually getting interrupted by S4. Koro will be able to glimmer cape himself away to safety.
Yeah, very nice lightning bolt to be able to intercept that long animation, the split earth stun. And Secret, this is their best opportunity when the Schmall gonna pick off.
Smile already used the stun. Yule Scepter up, Blink Dagger 1 second. Now he comes down. The stuns and the damage from Arteezy. Smile can tank through a lot. The Fissure can't buy the space. 30 seconds on the sideline and PPD. He's locked here. He forced out to Blink Dagger up to try and get close enough for this Echo Slam damage. No follow up stun. He's down for the count. 60 seconds, but more importantly, that ulti's down for 2 minutes. But look down the bottom lane. The creep wave is coming in towards the tier 3 tower. The fear is already coming back to defense. Yeah, I think he realizes what Arteezy can do.
He's really hoping to be able to force a TP out from that bottom lane, but it's just not going to happen. Secret has smelled blood in the water, and they're going to strike right here, I think. The PPP, even if he does come back, even if he does have a buyback here, they could force that, and they also know he doesn't have Echo Slam, which is a critical factor. So Secret must go uphill here. They must take advantage of the situation they bought themselves.
Oh, there's your lightning through both Plasma Field as well as Lightning Storm. Smail even try and throw a little deeper one in Secret. Okay,
oh, wow.
Now how do you go high ground when the creep wave can't even survive to get up there?
All right, well, they're just now going to have to play, I guess, for another opportunity. Find a pickoff, try and look for that space uphill. The problem is, I don't think they have any smokes left. None in the shop and none in inventory. So it doesn't look like they have that kind of plate in order to allow a pickoff. So they're just gonna have to outmaneuver, I think, Evil Geniuses. EG, they can do one or two things here. They can go for a very aggressive smoke play and try to catch a Secret out of guards, or they can go ahead and stay very defensive and just wait out the Aegis.
Well, they might have found one. We've got a little ball of light hovering over the riverbed. They caught a glimpse of him for a moment. Yeah, he's backed up now. So Secret realizing EG are all missing. So Maldus walks underneath their very old wall they put on that bottom river, which is about to time out. And yep, no one in the tree lines. The universe is searching for him. And there's just nothing. There's nothing at all for him. But at the same time, I doubt they're going to be too sad about this. EG, if you can find a pickoff, that's terrific. But you've already gone through 3 minutes of this duration of the Aegis of the Immortal. So Arteezy may not get the best use out of this. Not unless Secret can force something within the next minute or so. And that's exactly what I think looking to do. He's got 6.2k gold on the Zed. Just yeah, run it. Like, you could just run it straight down top. So 2 minutes left on it. Watch that timer. If we hit 53.30, then no Arteezy is not going to be walking around with immortality.
Buybacks are going to be pretty critical here. On the Radiant side, we only have Razor and the Leshrac who have buyback. The rest are actually just a little bit separate.
He's up so far. Zai's coming in with the Glimmer Cake. They're trying to kill our puppy, and they are going to isolate him at the same time. Zai not make it easy. They snowball in. PPD, Echo Slam is available, and maybe he can survive. No, he can't TP out in time. They've lost two. The Nova coming in. Some mail needs to win, but it's easy. Actually locked up by Ali 2000. Now Zai will trigger off the cheese. They have down. Well, Ken Dazzle on that ball. He doesn't want to buy back. He's just alive. He's still locked in, and then Storm Ball. They get the control. The Snowball is chasing up the Flying Rat, but it's not going to be enough on Fear. Battling up against the rest of Secret, the Snowball up. Fear at least gets rid of the sigils and can really move for the Shard. He locks him in. Samal comes back in again with Universe. Sorry, Howie on the front line. The Shiva's guard by space, and Fear actually has time. He's draining the damage. 168 points, Arteezy. Locked inside the Snowball. He's holding him in, but where's the stun? They go to Fear, Samal. Pulse Nova, Zai's going to go down. He's so low, the Glimmer came. They see him with the Sentry Ward. They've got him down. S4's trying to push in the middle lane. In the meantime, and Arteezy adding pressure on top. They do not want EG to push.
Samael coming in big. That was AUI 2000, though. That was the reason he was able to turn that fight with a beautiful Winter's Curse to stall up that whole entire entry. Secret could have, I think, crushed that fight with the onset, but Winter's Curse stalled him up, and then a beautiful embrace later on in the
bottom
fight.
The
to be able to save
is a level 2 coming in. That's Samael on the back of Universe setting up for S4. If they can get this pickoff, it's a huge window opportunity. And there's going to be the denial through the Bloodstone, but that's still 43 seconds that Zeus is on the sidelines.
And he's now down to 7 Bloodstone charges. Boy, that buyback from Samael definitely paying off now. He picks up the Boot of Travel level 2, TPs into the Razor to be a part of one kill on the Tusk, now gets to be a part of another death on the Zeus. He's back up to 9 Bloodstone charges.
And he also has the full Scythe of Vias completed. Another big item to be picked up and then consumed. The Moonshot has been consumed by Arteezy. 4.4k gold still on him.
I kind of feel like Evil Geniuses, unless they want to go for a pickoff play with this recent Scythe device. Ooh, that Stormhammer actually snagging both Universe. and Fear in that middle lane. But again, unless they want to go for a pickoff play at the Blink Dagger Scythe of Ice reveal, which it seems like that's the play here. This is very risky, though, because they don't have any buyback. Secret actually have all of theirs, and they should kind of know with the way that Samael, Secret...
There it is. Blink Dagger, Scythe of Ice, and Puffy dead on the stun. Pulse Nova, they can't through the Dazzle. He still has buyback. All of Secret have buyback. But it looks like EG are ready to push down the bottom lane.
Yeah, Evil Geniuses may just stumble into a bad play here. Secret, with all those buybacks, probably can win the fight. And if EG do not get enough kills, don't manage to get buyback gold for some of these heroes, or still left with timers, Secret can then just five-man down middle, potentially take a full lane of racks.
Here they come. Fortification triggered. They'll protect the racks, but the Fidget's on S4. Follow-up stun by Samael. Not going to work. There was the four-star falling to safety by S4. And with the Glimmer Cape, he can move back the front. Sphere already on those front lines. Being punched around by the Walrus Punch, but Owie able to embrace him up. So Fia locked in, controlled. Yeah, can he actually back out? Maybe not. There's Alder Martins. He can't actually do anything. He's down 120 seconds on the sideline, but the bike can bring him back up in time. But then Fia, he's still just standing on the front lines, doing the work. Puppy, now he'll drop. There's a triple buyback, a quad buyback, in fact, from Secret. Universe trying to give this life back, and then will blink himself away to safety. They actually get out after taking at the melee racks with mass amounts of buybacks by Secret.
Insanely good play from Evil Geniuses. I mean, the setup there, again, AOI, seeing that Sven was running forward, not opting to go for the roster because the Oz via static link that was going to be available there. He instead tries to jump AOI, but the thing is, AOI saw him coming and had the Winter's Curse queued up on him. So the moment that Sven blinks in, he instantly gets Winter's Curse. He does manage to get a stun off on AOI. He doesn't manage to eliminate that Winter Wyvern, who's been such a bane of his existence so far, and they just easily clean him up, and then the rest of Secret quickly fall. And then EG, on top of that, managing to back away before they're punished by the buybacks. They just managed to force out so much for Secret, and now have bought themselves a gigantic economical advantage. Look at that gold graph.
20,000 is what EG have so far here in game number one, and they're looking to come down middle lane and maybe make a bigger dent. This money needs to kick back up again as well for EG, and they may even, it's not even worth waiting out the time for Samael. He's got 3 minutes without a buyback available. So EG starts to be a little bit more careful about where they're going. I love how Tufia, while realizing that there is no Monkey King bar, just buys a Talisman of Evasion before coming up high ground because he got the BTs, so can easily just TP back into the fight after a buyback. So they attack into the tier 3 tower. The Eye of the Storm going to work there. The Mask of Madness being repurchased by Arteezy. He's trying to have another play. And Fear, there's just no way to kill him just yet. Maybe now, lock him in with the shards. In they come for the Walrus Punch, but Fear, four-starved away. He's got the space on him. And Secret, they're being baited out. They're actually asking them to come outside the base and fight. And yeah, Zai with the shards, they found Fear. Snowball's coming in. Maybe he can get the Walrus Punch up, but Owie still waiting there. Embraces up Fear. They haven't got the kill, and back Zai being isolated. The double stun there. Smori can't help out with the damage, and Fear force up top the shards. Can't lock him in. Secret, they can't find the openings. In fact, Samael wants to slow him up. They dive in with the Icarus into the Shivas as well. S4 too slow, and with the stuns, we're going to lose the Zeus. S4's down for the count. He has buyback available, or he can wait the 1 minute while Universe wants to go for more. The Nova is up and running, but maybe they can just five-man force it down mid. They've got the numbers.
Evil Geniuses, they can easily, I think, take a second lane of racks here and maybe even finish off that range racks at bottom lane. They're going to spend a little time healing, but there's no reason they shouldn't try and push uphill.
They'll come in 15 seconds.
Zeus.
They'll come in now 13 seconds, yeah, 12 seconds. Wait for Fear to have bot. BTs. That's all they require. At the same time, by the time he TP's in, that's exactly the same time Roshan's born. If Secret are capable of winning this fight, they can get back in by taking a quick Roshan. That's a big if.
Force the buyback and then back away to Roshan. Maybe the best play, but Secret are going to be able to get this fight. It looks like they'll finally get an initiation.
Fear still on the front lines. There's your Storm Bolt. Fear down a half line. Day got a Lightning Bolt. Fear having to be embraced up pretty early here. To keep it, man. There's the jump in. Walrus Punch on Samael. They're very low on the course. Samael backing up. Remember, this buyback is not available to him for another minute, so they can pick him off. They have a big opening. The Lightning just try and slow him down if possible. Ice Shard off cooldown. Try and lock him in. They found Owie. He's a big one. Crit him down. 1400 on the damage. And then an isolated Nova. They can't free up this Phoenix. And they're going to. Down for the count. Double kill for RT. Samael luckily able to TP out in time. TPD as well. The Shard's division. The snowball. He
Lesh got him on the cliff. How did he find him? Well, Bam can help that answer that question. It's a triple kill for Arteezy. Critting from the mud column on the low ground to get the kill on the high ground.
Excellent play from Arteezy, but what a catch from Zai. They need, you have to get excited about a pickoff like that. Yeah, you say, it's just a supporter shaker, though. What can it really mean? Well, Secret need every pickoff they can.
How's he doing this in the mid? He wants to jump off to rest, fall by more space, but Zai with a snowball available. Fear's going to come back in. Zai losing life so quickly. He's down. No buyback. That's a 100-second window opened up by EG, but they're still licking their wounds from the last fight.
Team Secret gotta go for the split push play here. They gotta go through the top lane and force Evil Geniuses on the defensive while they wait outside.
Oh, I don't want to. It's S4, Kuro, and Arteezy. Like, if they also knew, if they only knew Roshan was there, but then again, is that even going to help? I know having a second life during these fights is probably going to be useful. The cheese won't be as much.
They should know. Roshan's been up for a little while here. If it was an early Roshan, which I didn't see, we'd be getting towards the end of the timer, or maybe we've already reached it, so...
The Dazzle Weave just scattered it out.
Yeah.
So, Secret are very well aware that this Roshan's alive. The relocate is up if they just want to pop in. But what's Sven gonna do now? Drop this Mask of Madness that Arteezy reinvested back into? The Moonshard, the attack speed was just not enough.
Fear can pick up his butterfly, and that's huge, right? The Sven has no room for an MKB. Even if he had the gold, he'd have to drop Mask of Madness, pick up the MKB, and again, then you have a six-slotted Sven. There's no growth there available.
And if Fear actually buys the butterfly, he doesn't have buyback, and he doesn't want to risk that at this point of the game. Not when we've just crossed the hour mark here in game one. And Arteezy, whatever they can do to stop this Creekwave from entering the base, they're doing it. Lightning Bolt, stuns, Storm Bolt, everything they've got. Now they dump it. The X and Arteezy, they need to try and save him.
Really?
There
is
the Gary, okay, down.
Surveillor, he took so much damage to inflict that into Arteezy, and they're healing him up as quick as they possibly can. Fear retreating back out. But S4 wants to keep up with this. He's got 4 staff available. Arteezy with Blink Dagger off cooldown. Storm Bolt can't get close to PPD, but one hits down the creep wave. Remember Roshan's still up PPD with a stun. That Mask of Madness is turned on, but damage. Okay, now it's turned off. I don't have the amplification, but you do still have the Dazzle behind him with that Shallow Grave points. And they might be able to find, okay, yeah, looking for every single ward they can possibly find of EG that might be watching Secret's movements.
I was a little bit scared there with that Fissure laid out on the Sven. I was afraid the Team Secret 2 times in a row would be baited into chasing Evil Geniuses and immediately run into a bad fight. EG have shown incredibly good kiting abilities against Secret going into this late game.
Here we go again. Puppy starts with a weave. At least gonna drop down some mail as well as Fear's armor. The ice shards come in, and with Zai, well, he wants a snowball. It's more of a fear thing right on him, and then they embrace him up. Some mail still here on the front lines. Have you coming a little bit closer as Fear is still the only soul tank, but they get rid of the melee racks, but Fear isolated by the shot. That'd be 4 star. Now comes Arteezy onto Samael. He brought him down. 45 seconds on the sideline. Wants to find more. Blink Dagger still on cooldown. The shards come up. They get the vision of PPD, but this time they will not be able to stun him before the TP is completed. But with Lashrike down for 35 seconds, they're making a beeline for immortality, and that's Roshan.
Yeah, the problem is I don't think Roshan means nearly as much as it used to in this game.
It could be Cheese to Kuro, though. That's one big thing, and maybe you could also have like Tuskar with an Aegis the Immortal, so when Zai jumps in, you can soak up a lot more.
It'll definitely be a factor, there's no denying that, but it's just not the same as when you used to have an extra slot on your carry. You can give him the Aegis. They're gonna have to give the Aegis away to someone else. It will be S4, and sure enough, the cheese is picked up. Well, actually, didn't go to Kuro, went to Poppy instead. Would be surprised though if he passed it off to Kuro. It's just too much value coupled with the tether.
Well, for now, he's holding on to it. The full butterfly is now completed on Fear. Buyback's available. We've got to keep watching that counter too. Winter Wyvern and Zeus are the only two heroes that do not have buyback on the map, so that's one apiece. But here comes Secret. The smoke down the mid, they're trying to do this sneaky beaky light and then just rip apart the EG bait. Fortification is available for EG, however, it is not available for Secret.
Can Arteezy make this game
up! Actually, four-staffed himself and then blinked away, revealed it, and PPD in for the double stun. Fear also the front lines. Arteezy blinks away after going for the Storm Bolt. He does not want to be part of this, but Univer might make him part of it. Shiva's guard down to trigger the Storm Bolt, protecting Arteezy for the moment. Where they want to go to, they're facing up the universe. Can they kill him? Nope, they actually just use it to delay the blink daggers away. Secret desperately trying to disengage. Zai with a blink dagger in 5 seconds time. He's running away. EG, can they find him? Yeah, they can. Owie's on the back. Now Zai, Storm Bolt's also available. trouble. He can buy himself some time, and there it is again. It's all about wasting time while Samael is chasing down after Puppy. They will lose Zion River, and Puppy will go down to Samael. Two down for Secret. EG, open up the window again. Opportunity is knocking.
Two rounds down, two heroes down. Team Secret are going to be forced into double buybacks here as Evil Genius steamroll right through middle and head up to the top lane for the Mega Creeps, or potentially just straight to Throne.
Remember, though, you still have the Aegis Immortal on S4. The fresh Lincoln Sphere over on Arteezy means that he's also got space to move, and they just saw PPD plant down the aggressive ward. They'll get rid of this as quickly as they can. They do not want to have EG having any kind of superiority with Vision from Mail, dropped by Half-Life, the Storm Ball, stopping PPD from getting that fissure off as well. Arteezy, he's gotta be careful. Hands up, but then again, Zai tossing his Samael up, and the Nova, perfect position on EG. They can't get rid of this. I'll have to take the summon. PPD just jumps in. The sun will be there. Trump finds in space from Universe. Secret, there is the buyback from Arteezy, but Puppy caught outside the base. The Telegrave can't do enough. S4, maybe the cheese can keep Puppy alive a little bit longer. And Fear low, but then again, Arteezy can't read Fear. Embrace up again. He's trying to rip him. One hit, he can't even do that. They have to come back inside the base. S4 for the jump in by Samael. Where's the damage? There it is from Arteezy. Some will be there, but then against Samael, the buyback. They're using economy to win this game, Universe. That's where Samael will be onto, directly on the hero. S4 back under the tier 4 towers. Koro, the save. He's keeping S4 alive. The Stormball as well. They drop him in deeper. The top rack still up. Relocate up. He's actually pulling him in closer towards the fight. Buyback is still about from S4, but Arteezy stranded, possibly dead. Koro is still there, but he's dropping quickly, but it's too much damage. EG, they look like they'll take another right. GG! EG will take it. 65 minutes and an epic battle. They take game one of the best of five in the grand final.
This is exactly the way this best of five is supposed to be worked. Evil Genius is throwing hero after hero in an all-in play at top to finish out this game, and there was just nothing Secret could do with this kind of draft. They fought so hard, but unfortunately, when pushed this